prepared an idea for a show. Tell me if you would watch this. So, it's a live stream. So if you're wondering, is it uploads? Is it short? Is it live? It's live. And in this live stream, it basically works as a giveaway slash raffle of sorts. Avoiding the term raffle because that could imply gambling, not gambling. Gambling, you pay some physical amount and you get some possibility of a reward. Not gambling. As in buying a raffle ticket. It's more like if all you had to do was comment. If terms of entering said raffle was engaging in that live stream, then people would have the incentive to watch it in droves. Because you just watch this thing, maybe comment, and now you could win a coffee mug or a Super Nintendo or, you know, that's part of the fun too. It could be super interesting, not knowing what's next. Lots of viewability power there. So, you draw a crowd in the possibility that they win something, either grand or small. Probably starting small, and companies with things to offer for the advertisement that would be gained from that have incentive to give the show things to give away. And though I would not see any kind of profit because their sacrifice is essentially handed over, I'm essentially committing work to make that happen. I get the benefit of that taking place on my channel and all of the, you know, YouTube possibility, monetization, blah, blah, blah. And if you draw comparisons, that's really not too far off from the business model of The Price is Right. They kind of do that. Home Shopping Network. You know, give us some shit to sell and or give us prizes. We have now won over the appeal of the audience, and that's the part where we came from anyway. Price is Right might get some kind of contract for a day where, like, maybe every time, you know, like your car is shown on that show, you pay them $1,000 or something. I'd be willing to bet it could be the opposite. A lot of contracts work the opposite direction. It might be The Price is Right pays a certain amount every time a product is shown. It seems hard to imagine that they'd sign up for that. But anyway, more or less something that a single person could pull off, and that then lies the difficulty twofold, one of which is you have to be at a particular audience size for that to be viable as an exchange. And if you're, you know, under 100 subs like I am, it's not happening on this channel anytime soon. So you kind of have to have existing footing for that to be meaningful or something you can tap into, I would think. But maybe not. You know, sometimes ideas take off. Sometimes, you know, people like a good internet success story. Now I'm gonna be careful and not say that then I make that like a get rich quick seminar or anything like that. Or any kind of like weird coaching or whatever. Just be your friendly dude like I am here and now. But I'd be standing in front of a camera. Or not, it might just be my voice. Whatever performs better. I think people might prefer to see a person. Get myself on camera and go live and show some shit off and sell that space on my show to companies to have their businesses promoted. learn it out there. It probably already exists. And like I say, you might already have to be somebody for that kind of endorsement to make any sense. The other thing is I've got my own store. Why not do as I said, but with my own goods, and advertise my own store like I do with these drinks? And I say hell to the yes, but I do not have a budget to just come up with all of these things to give away. It would be an investment, either to somebody very delicate in business stature, or it would mean me already having been, a household name enough to where people would be interested in that. Now, the other thing I've learned about this is that when I was getting my coat deal, where am I going? I'm the wrong way. Is it these companies? Sorry, everybody. They've already decided in their boardrooms who they want to invite for their pitches. It's not just because you had the idea and you even spent the time to ask a million people that that's even really viable. It's kind of one of those things where you gotta be invited a little bit, from my understanding. That doesn't mean I'm gonna stop in my tracks. I'll always see how far you can get on your own, and ask for help when you need it. But don't ask for help until you've done what you can on your own. That's the best time to ask for help, is you've already done everything. Like, look, I got this great idea, but I can't do these things, but I've taken these steps. These are the steps that would otherwise not have been taken had I not, thought of it being important to present that to you first. Basically showing I need to focus on this laugh. I'm bullshitting too much. But yeah, what do you think of my channel idea? Do you think it should be an entirely different channel? Do you think it should be on an existing channel? Maybe I can borrow somebody's channel. Maybe the advertisers know somebody in the business, or you have a strong enough channel and I can just sell the idea. Kind of hard to claim ownership of that idea, having just put it out in the world for free, but in a way I kind of like telling sick ideas on these, because it kind of poor man's publishes it. There's a date that said thing was said or came up with. Lost it. And I basically get to timestamp all of this stuff, which is better than just trying to claim something that was taken with no documentation. It's also very loose and not even a verbal contract that somebody would even respect. Said contract. Implied contract. That'll happen. I'll get to yapping and lose races. Okay, this one will have no banter. Banter free. We're also doing a promotion at my store, Speak of, Let me know what your favorite car sticker is in my sticker section at segment.click. Segment.click is the URL. And first person to bring up this offer will get their favorite car sticker sent to them. Or maybe sent to a location of their choice. Maybe sent to them is uncomfortable. Sent to where you want me to send it. And nothing weird. Don't have me send it to, like, something cringe. All right. let's carry on. Weather looks good. How many laps? Just one lap. The corners on this level are gonna be pretty gnarly in this car. Okay, we're down to like 2 frames a second. It's all good. This car come out with like the PS4 Pro or something like that. Odds are we'll probably hit the wheelie with this car. Might even take a flight. More like a lion. Roar! Nope. No such luck. I don't know if you can wheelie off of that in this game. whispers if you call myself the Meister. Redemption arc for Gabriel, they say. Damn. Okay, I placed second all around. Okay. How they're gonna have me do a Ferrari race. Did that fulfill the mission? Okay, is that the last of the maps? Group B rally cars. Well, let's have a look at the race requirements, because I do have a rally car to use, but depending on which cars I can get, might depend on how much money I'm willing to spend on it. Okay, so we're here, get the Audi. Here, you got the Renault, I think that is. And here you get the Focus. So I think I like the Audi out of all of which means we gotta. Oh wait, is it? Damn, you could take anything. Let's throw some dirt tires on this fucking it might be only things that are all-wheel drive. Let's see. Something of the sort. It's, I can't see because I don't have the dirt tires on it. That's what's. Okay. Can we compete in this then? Looks like we can. I could do more with the performance points. Do I have any weight on this car? I do not. Okay, well, let's just rock it out and see what happens. I thought I was gonna have to put money into my rally car that I have. I've got a Toyota Rally. God. I think I could probably just use any all-wheel drive, which is awesome. I'm as low as possible to the ground, which is a bit of a no-no, but I don't care. That's a rally, it's like a Honda rally. Damn.
Thank you.
get some breathing room. I didn't get totally screwed. Did I never start my clock? That would be really bad. I never started the clock. I don't know how much time is on this. Let's do one more and clip it after that. I'm also thinking I don't want to use this car as a rally car. Well, actually, you know what? It depends. If the other ones are road, if it's still a road, yeah, I don't want to do any more dirt on this car. Just not the one. Okay, are the others dirt? This one looks like it's road. Okay. It's like racing soft. Oops. That's sports soft. I never got racing soft for this car? Holy shit. That's crazy. To add some weight or something. Yeah, I never bought that either. Oh, funny. I've used this car so much and I haven't got any of its basic stuff. Restrictor might not even be such a bad idea. Okay. Using soft. How much add we finna weight add? How much weight we finna add? Max. Still over. Take some power away. Okay, are we in it? It might be refreshing to not go a million miles an hour. It's still gonna be going hella fast. I'm surprised I never thought to put on the better tires when I still had, more things to improve. Funny that. Doing. Favorite turn, just the dark. losing. Oh my god, guys. I think I'm gonna make podium. I think the game really doesn't want me to use this car on this event. So we'll set up the Audi and try this again. Where we at? Not quite, guys. Do that next time with a rally car. Alright, I'm gonna clip the episode here. Thank you so much for watching. Please visit my shop. It's that glowing name there. You see segment.click blinking. That's what you type into your URL, and it'll take you right there. Thank you so much.